You were raised as a slave, but must discard those traits and learn to control others. And I have just the task for that end. Meet this driveling excuse for an acolyte. He will be your victim.
Victim, huh? This sounds like it could be fun.
This is not an idle diversion, acolyte. A short while ago, there was what we call an unauthorized murder here in the academy. A rivalry among apprentices resulted in death. Interrogate him. Make him tell you who committed this crime at any cost.
I can absolutely do that.
Excellent. Get to it then. I look forward to watching you work.
Please, don't hurt me. I don't know anything.
Scream, weakling. I want to hear your suffering.
Please, don't do that again. I'll do anything.
What shouldn't I do again? This?
Stop! Please! All right, I'll talk. He'll kill me, but I'll talk. The murderer is an apprentice named Essor Kaon. You have to protect me, or he'll kill me.
You may be mistaken.
Kaon's master is a Dark Council member. Might as well try fighting the Emperor himself. Kaon won't get so much as a reprimand. But when Kaon finds out, he'll come after me.
Maybe then you'll shut up.
Of course. It's not your problem. Why should you care? Maybe if I'm lucky, Kaon will put me out quickly. Oh, I don't want to die.
You don't have to tell me. I heard the name loud and clear, though I sorely wish I hadn't. Essor Kaon. Kane's master is a Dark Council member. I'd be a fool to oppose him. But anyway, your trial here is done. I will send my commendations to Overseer Harkon. You may return to him now.
What are you going to do about the murderer?
Nothing, although the apprentice's master will have to be informed. It's not my business to dispense justice, certainly not where the Dark Council is concerned.
That makes a certain sense.
I'm glad you think so. It has been most pleasant watching you work, acolyte. Truly, I wish you the best of luck in your remaining trials.
I had been looking forward to cutting another one of you down, but it looks like I'll be spared the trouble. Unsurprisingly, Nylock has gone missing. Also, unsurprisingly, Fon has passed his first trial. It's only a matter of time before he tramples you all underfoot.
I'll tear you apart where you stand, slave!
Patience, Fon. An accident in the tombs is much more convincing. Now the lot of you know your next task. Go. I want to speak to Fon and our latecomer. Now, slave. Zin says you handled yourself expertly, and as much as I find this difficult to believe, Lord Zash is satisfied with his evaluation. Undoubtedly, Zin helped you in some way, but you will not have his help on the next trial. Both you and Fon will have trials of intellect, trials that test your ability to apply your understanding of the Force to solve problems.
You don't expect a slave to be a match for me in intellect. I've been trained under the greatest teachers.
Calm down, Fon. I certainly do not expect this slave to be a match for you. That's why you will have separate trials.
You don't need to dumb down the trials for me. Though I'm sure Fawn would appreciate the help.
You're only digging your own grave. Fawn, you will go to the library on the second floor of the Academy and translate the following texts for Lord Zash.
Yes, Overseer.
Slave, deep in the ancient, monster-infested tomb of Marka Ragnos, there is a holocron filled with dark secrets and encased in a great stone monument. No one has figured out how to release the holocron from its stone prison in over 1,000 years. You will bring this holocron to me, or you will die.
Well, it beats going to the library, I suppose.
Spoken like the idiot you are. You will bring back the holocron, or hope that the spirit of Marka Ragnos himself returns to end your miserable existence. Now go.
To browse our inventory. Thank you for your patronage.
You wear the robes of a Sith, but you are not one of us, alien. I look at you, and I wonder, are you among the truly loyal, or do you hide treason in your heart?
Who are you?
I am Inquisitor Arzanin, head of Academy Security, and do not think you can so easily deflect my question. Intelligence reports indicate this valley shelters traitors. Acolytes who seek to destroy our Emperor's carefully built order and replace it with their own weak-minded heresies.
They hide among the faithful and obedient. But make no mistake, they will destroy us all, given the chance.
We've watched as the traitors scuttle about this valley and plot against us. We know their faces and their names. It is the Emperor's will that the sands of Korriban be slaked with the blood of these traitors. Prove your allegiance by executing them.
Are you sure we shouldn't just arrest them? They could be shown the error of their ways.
Treason is a crime with only one punishment. Death. If you lack the resolve to uphold the law, that will say much about you.
I'll give you the means to identify the traitors. Eliminate enough of them to prove your loyalty, Then return to Inquisitor Arzanen.
I'll be watching your progress with great interest. Go now. See that the Emperor's will be done. I watched you deal with those traitors. Well done. That was an impressive display of loyalty. Take this reward as a token of the Emperor's favor, and wear this badge. It marks you as a defender of our Empire.
Stay vigilant. Our enemies lurk where you least expect them.
Confirmed. Friend, if you're headed out by the Tukata, Lord Varrison is paying actual credits for bone marrow samples. Varrison's doing some sort of experiment for Lord Renning. The less details we know, the better, I'm sure.
bone marrow samples. Lord Renning will be pleased. You may go.
I'd heard we were evaluating alien competency to be Sith. How fascinating to finally meet a test subject. I trust the sight of a messy operating table doesn't disturb you?
Your lab looks like the inside of a beast's belly.
So quick to turn away in disgust. You're denying yourself knowledge and power. This used to be a Tukata, the hound-like creatures infesting Korriban's tombs. On the surface, nothing special. But I alone can see this creature is an expression of pure dark side energy. Aggression made manifest.
Amazing. How did you learn that?
The Force told me so. It speaks to me. The Force is alive. It expresses its will in the physical world. This Tukata was one such form.
The Force is no more alive than your beast.
Your eyes are shut to possibilities. Open them. I've dissected hundreds of Tukata, forging a direct connection to the dark side. Each beast I examine advances me toward perfect unity. I now stand at a new frontier, but find myself thwarted. My most perfect specimen, a Tukata mutant, escaped to the tombs before I could analyze it.
Life is rough, but at least it's interesting.
You don't understand. I've lost a vital key to unlocking the dark side's true essence. You acolytes delve those tombs on your trials. You could hunt that Tukata for me and retrieve its perfect brain. My apprentice, Melora, saw which tomb the mutant beast fled into. Find out what she knows, assist me, and you will be rewarded.
Why not send your apprentice to recover this beast?
She's more suited to the laboratory than the tombs. She lacks your fire, I'm afraid. Ask Melora where to seek the Tukata and return to me when you have its brain.
Seeking Lord Renning's lost pet, are you? Don't waste your time. That fool's research is pointless.
How did you discover this?
My master is insane. Wasn't it obvious when you spoke to him? Renning deludes the Dark Council into believing he's advancing Sith knowledge. The truth is, he wastes the Empire's time and resources dissecting mindless animals. But if his experiments were discredited, he would be banished, and I would be rewarded.
Tell the Dark Council he's insane. I'm sure they'll listen.
Don't be naive. The Dark Council would never believe the word of an apprentice over her master. Look, just a minor alteration to the mutant Tukata's brain would allow me to reveal my master as a fraud. Bring me the brain before delivering it to Lord Renning, and I'll make it worth your while.
Betraying your master carries considerable risk.
The greater the risk, the greater the reward. For both of us. The mutant Tukata escaped to the tomb of Mark of Ragnos. It's much larger than the others, so it's easy to spot. Return to me with the brain before you see Lord Renning, and I'll take care of the rest.
Sergeant Garrus, turns out the rumors were true. Some of the sentries we lost down here aren't dead. They lost their minds, just like the Acolytes. Doesn't mean we're gonna have any easier a time getting the research supplies back, though. The crates are secured with multi-locks. If we're going to open these things without frying the contents, we'll need to get all the sentries' code cylinders back. I don't think negotiation is an option. The men aren't keen to take down their old comrades, but we'll do what we can. Once we have the code cylinders, we'll crack open the supply crates and get back. Tavon out.
Yeah.
peace is a lie. There is only passion. Perhaps calm is necessary.
Just open, damn it!